Hello everyone, welcome back to Being Deepa once again. Thank you so much for coming here and thank you so much for all your love, your comments and your suggestions. And if this is your first time here, welcome to you too. Well, this is the place where we try to decode the puzzles of life, one puzzle at a time. So 2019 is finally coming to an end and 2020 is here. Time to reflect, time to look back and feel proud and happy about all the things that went really well last year. And time to feel guilty about all the things that didn't. We feel guilty of not being able to lose that weight or travel to that place or do that course or not being able to push ourselves a little more. If you too are in that zone of making new promises to yourself to help you become a better version of your older self, then you've come to the right place. Today, I'm going to share 5 extremely important things that you can start doing this year to help you achieve that dream that you have set for yourself. So let's not waste more time and let's get started. Here we go. The first pointer that I would strongly, strongly recommend and suggest to you would be to start writing a journal or a diary. Journal writing can help you immensely. If you have been trying to bring changes in your life, your diary has the potential to be both a therapist and a dear friend who listens and helps without judgments or interruptions. Writing about what goes in your head helps you deal with the toxic and negative feelings. It helps you organize your thoughts and set priorities. Once you start writing, you can look for patterns, whether it's your mood, habit, or general behavior, and can decode what exactly could be a possible cause for your mood swings or your behavior. Writing a diary or journaling also helps you prioritize and analyze your daily tasks, monthly goals. It's like a permanent record of our goals. When you write tasks in the morning and cross it before the day is over, that feeling brings not just happiness, but a sense of competence and confidence both. You can take any notebook, any blank notebook, and make whatever columns that you want to and just go ahead, write your heart out and let me know how does it go. The second and extremely, extremely important pointer that I would want to suggest you do this year will be to find a trait that you're struggling with, something that you really want to change or improve in your life, and then go after it with all your might. If you would like to work on your organizational skills and your time management, instead of just thinking and not doing anything about it, why don't you just order Organised Minds by Daniel Levitin? If you think you are a procrastinator and waste your precious time in just dreaming about work and not actually doing it, watch the TED Talk of Tim Urban, Inside the Mind of Master Procrastinator. You would love it. It's amazing. Similarly, if you want to make new friends and influence people, there is Dale Carnegie to your help. And if there is any habit that you want to work on, then there's always James Clear's Atomic Habits. If you're struggling to find your inner creative soul, then I would strongly suggest Elizabeth Gilbert's The Big Magic. And if you want to read about meditation or being in the moment, then there can't be a better book than by Eckhart Tolle's The Power of Now. These are the books that have the capability to change your life, including many, many more. My point is, we are living in a time where we have all the resources. The books are very cheap. You can just go online and watch those TED Talks. You can listen to these free podcasts. There are free audiobooks, and all this is at your disposal. The only thing that you have to do is to decide this year, I want to work on my organizational skills or on my speaking skills, on my confidence, on my public speaking, on my leadership qualities, on my confidence. Whatever you do, there is enough help. There are enough resources for you to take help from. I'm going to put all these links in my description below so that you can go ahead and check some of these out. But don't forget to recognize that one habit, that one thing that you want to change in your life, and start working in it with all your might. The third pointer that I have is for mostly women, or especially moms. And that pointer is money goals. Being a woman, I know we all have enough excuses to not care or being not aware about how money is invested in our house, how much savings do we have, how are we really planning our financial future. But trust me, if you have not done so, this is the year that I would really, really suggest you or urge you to be a little more financially wise, aware, you know, to have a little more financial knowledge than you already have. I know many women who have been working for decades but have no clue where their money is, how is that invested, and is that even the right place, or is that even the best place to invest, and how much to invest, how much to spend, what are the right places to save. This is not really the conversation that we have in our houses. We just kind of put it all on our husbands or fathers, somehow thinking that we have enough problems to worry about, and this is something that we would rather not indulge in. But two brains are always better than one, and it's always good to have that conversation and know about mutual funds, know about stock markets, know about fixed deposits, properties, whatever you want to do or have done, having a grip on the things. And if you want to pick one point out of whatever I have discussed, I think this is something that you must do this year. I would just request and suggest you to be a little more money wise this year. And if I can give you just one tip, that would be save before spending. The percentage that you want to save every month, whether it's 15% or 20% of your salary, that should just get out of your account before you start spending anything. That's my tip. I would love to know, what have you thought about doing about this money thing? Please write it in the comments below. And that brings us to our next pointer. My next pointer might sound very simple, but it's extremely significant and powerful. It is knowing yourself. Yes, I know we all think that we know ourselves, but at whatever age you are, I think it is crucial for you to have an idea of who you really are. And trust me, the diary writing that I told you is going to help you immensely and critically in that. But apart from that, I feel physical things to mental things to emotional things about ourselves are so important. What makeup looks good on me? How best can I do makeup? What are the products that my skin loves? What kind of foundation complements my skin tone? What are the lipstick shades that I just need to go and grab and I know I'm safe? What kind of hair products? What kind of hairstyles? What kind of clothes? What kind of shoes? What type of heels? Some of the things you should be absolutely sure about, so that you know this is you. This accentuates and helps your body type, helps your skin. I think that's one thing that you need to know. And if you have not yet started writing about it, please do. Apart from the physical thing, also the mental and emotional triggers. So what upsets you? What gets your goat? You know, what makes you snap? What makes you go mad? And also, what are the scents, perfumes, or the songs that can really calm you down? Is it lavender? For me, it's lavender. But you know what I mean? The emotional and mental and physical aspects of you, of who you are, you need to know. Know yourself. Because knowledge, my friend, is the power. And this is the time to take power in your hand. Alright, so this is my fourth pointer, knowing yourself. And if you do that, please write to me, how do you find that information? How do you find that power once you have it? The last pointer today will be practicing gratitude. I've said it enough in my videos and I can't stress it enough. Most of the people, most of the autobiographies that I read, most of the videos that I watch of highly successful people, I feel that one thing that they all do is they practice gratitude. Because I do believe in a higher energy. I do believe that if we send out positive energies, they come back to us. And if we do count our blessings, if we thank the higher power for things, it all comes back multifold. So 5 minutes every day, if you can just write three things that you are happy about that day. I mean, it can't be the same things. Of course, we are happy about our parents, about family, about our house, about our spouse, about our kids. Yes, it's important to write about that. But apart from those constant things, what are you happy about today? Is that the cup of tea? Is that the sunlight? Is that the fact that you have warm blankets or a heater? Is that your friends? Is that the call that you have got from your dad? Three simple things that make you say thank you. You need to write those three things. And 21 days. Just give it a try for 21 days. I'm telling you, this is going to change your life. It's so powerful. Well, these are the five pointers that I have for you. Thank you so much for coming back here again. And if you have not yet subscribed to our channel, please do so, because that would only help me make more videos and more quality content. And I would love to know, what do you think about these five pointers? So please write it in the comments, subscribe to it, press the bell icon. And I wish you a very, very happy new year in advance. I'll see you in 2020. Take care. Bye-bye.